गुड मॉर्निंग चिल्ड्रन, दिस इज सीमा प्रभाकरन। वी आर गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विथ हिस्ट्री। सेकेंड लेसन, एस्टैब्लिशमेंट ऑफ द कंपनी पावर वी हैव कंप्लीटेड। टुडे वी विल बिगिन विद द सेकेंड पार्ट ऑफ द सेकेंड लेसन नेम्ड ग्रोथ ऑफ कॉलोनियल आर्मी एंड सिविल एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन। इन द बिगिनिंग द ब्रिटिश ईस्ट इंडिया कंपनी हैड एंटर्ड इंडिया एज ट्रेडर। At the same time, there were many other countries which were fighting for trade, and finally, East India Company won over the monopoly of trade in India. Subsequently, taking advantage of the political condition in India, the East India Company strengthened its position economically as well as politically. It conquered practically the whole of India by various means. Different techniques they used and different on different grounds they took control of areas. The British conquest of India caused great discontentment in the country. People were very angry. They were not happy with the way in which the Britishers were controlling India. It was mainly because the company was concerned about its own interest. Their entire strategy and efforts were directed towards safeguarding their own interest. During this time, Robert Clive established dual system of government in Bengal. As the name suggests, dual means double. Under this system, power was separated from responsibility. Though the responsibility to look after the welfare of the people lay with the Nawab, the actual power lay with the British or English. Weakness of the government could be blamed on the Indians while the company enjoyed its fruits. The company collected revenue out of which it spent very little on administration and rest was sent to England. Thus, the wealth of Bengal was gradually being drained off to England. Warren Hastings, the first Governor General of Bengal, played a significant role in the expansion of company power. By this time, the company had also established its power in Bombay and Madras. Hence, it became necessary to introduce a system of administration. British territories were broadly divided into administrative units, which were called presidencies. There were three main presidencies: Bengal, Madras, and Bombay, each ruled by a governor. The supreme head of the administration was the Governor General. The credit for introducing several administrative measures in the sphere of justice goes to Warren Hastings. That's all for today's class. Thank you and have a nice day. Stay home, stay safe.